And we are in for a meeting of the top two seeds coming into the competition. Viktor Lőrincz of Hungary, whose brother Tamás won Hungary's 20th wrestling gold medal yesterday. He takes on Zhan Beleniuk of Ukraine, the silver medalist from Rio de Janeiro.
Yeah, this should be an absolute cracker of a match, shouldn't it? And it was, well, he was shouting for his brother yesterday, and it was interesting to see because they look exactly the same as well. They look very, very similar, but there's 10 kilos difference between them.
3 years younger at 31, Viktor Lőrincz. The brothers from Cegléd, a famous spa town in the centre of Hungary.
Well, I'm almost sure that his brother will be absolutely there supporting him.
And a man who's been there or thereabouts for some time, Zhan Beleniuk of Ukraine, world champion going into the Rio Olympics. He won the silver medal. World champion coming into these Olympics. Does he win the gold on this occasion? The 30-year-old, one of the top names in the sport for such a long time. Koike from Japan, the hugely experienced referee, Koike Kuninori. Lovely moment for the referee as well, a home Olympics refereeing a gold medal contest. It's Viktor Lőrincz of Hungary against Zhan Beleniuk of Ukraine.
Well, these guys, from a tactical point of view as well, they'll have a plan, what they want to do. These opening seconds will just to get a feel of the opponent.
The enormous amount of work that has gone to getting to this stage of their careers, getting to the gold medal bout, and it is 6 minutes long.
Yeah, and it's, you can lose it, can't you, within just 20 seconds, or you can, you know, certainly I've seen Olympic Games go away, you know, Olympic gold medals can just be turned. It's not like tennis. A little bit longer in tennis and you can come back, can't you? But you can come back here as well, can't you? I mean, just something happens and it turns on its head.
Viktor Lőrincz, a man who has come back from the disappointment of losing in the bronze medal bout in Rio. Zhan Beleniuk certainly was a gentleman who felt some disappointment at taking the silver medal in Rio, coming in as the reigning world champion, lost to David Chakvetadze. Here is the opportunity for Lőrincz. There it was, gone again.
Yeah, it's so quick out of there, Beleniuk. He wasn't going to stay there, not for a second. And he almost looks casual, doesn't he, Beleniuk? He looks casual, as if he's just having a little tussle in a training arena, but he knows exactly when the opportunity comes, he changes pace and takes advantage of whatever his opponent's not doing at the time.
So gentle is his movement sometimes in how it appears, you almost forget how powerful he is.
Yeah, and both of these are really powerful wrestlers, but he's just, like I say, cool, calm and collected and just choosing his moment. Tactically, he knows exactly what he wants.
There's a genuine elegance to the wrestling of Zhan Beleniuk. At the moment, though, he trails.
I love it. how they use their head as well to get direction, and the heads come together. Stance playing a massive part.
So often a combat sport is described as a physical form of chess. It feels like it right now.
Well, that's exactly what that is. I mean, they know the game inside out, and this second period, I suspect that we'll see a change of pace. There's the head coming in all the time, using the head to change the direction, and like I say, just find that way through.
Viktor Lőrincz, Zhan Beleniuk. The second period underway, and there it is. There's our change of pace.
Absolutely. I mean, it was going to happen. One point up there to Lőrincz. And I'm not saying it doesn't mean anything, but it can just change, can't it?
Moment, Lawrence is coping with the change of pace from Beleniuk, but what he has to do is prove that he's attacking as well. Referee watching on to make a decision perhaps soon.
Yeah, now it's Beleniuk coming forwards. And this is where the experience comes in.
Well, this could be problematic. Beleniuk is not finding a way forwards. Referee's got a big decision to make.
Yeah, just one point in it, and now.
There we go. There it is. The inevitability that it was going to be. Lőrincz dropping down, and Beleniuk, with a minute and 54 seconds left in the bout, having not allowed Lawrence to get near him in the parterre, now has got a firmer looking grip on his opponent. Lawrence is defending with all he has. Is he caught? He is caught. It's two for Beleniuk. He takes the lead. And he's got another couple as well. That's brilliant from Beleniuk.
He knew exactly, didn't he? And just chooses his moment and then he pounces. Beleniuk now clearly ahead. And it came out totally different, didn't it, this second period?
If you are to become a world champion on two occasions, it's because you can take chances.
Yeah, and change the pace. And I keep saying that, but I mean, it was sometimes it just looked as if just simmering away there and then just went into a different gear. And that's what makes a great champion. 1 minute to hold on.
Zhan Beleniuk of Ukraine leads by 4 points. That is a catchable margin if Lőrincz can get a takedown onto the back. A single further point would start to make things really difficult for the Hungarian. Not that they're not difficult enough already, because with 45 seconds to go, it's starting to become a very long way back.
Yeah, Beleniuk's got to keep coming forwards. He can't just go back. Backwards, he can't afford to give away the advantage here.
Zhan Beleniuk is somebody who has acquired a great reputation in Ukraine. He's a respected politician. He was elected to the parliament in 2019. His father was a pilot who studied at the National Aviation Academy in Kiev, who died during the Rwandan Civil War. Beleniuk has spoken of his desire, when his career as a wrestler comes to an end, to be a force for good in the sport in Ukraine, in all sports in Ukraine. Well, he's going to be an even stronger force now, because he is going to be doing all of that as an Olympic champion. From silver in Rio to gold in Tokyo, he moves to central spot on the podium.
He was really calm, wasn't he? His first period was at a certain level, and his second period there just went into overdrive. Did everything that was expected there without taking any giant chances, any big mistakes, or chancing any big mistakes, should I say.
Viktor Lőrincz, who has already experienced the disappointment of defeat by Zhan Vensanovych in massive competitions, including the World Championships of 2019. In the final there, has experienced it once again at the Olympic Games. But for the Lőrincz brothers, it's been a superb competition. And for Viktor, he has a silver medal. But Beleniuk seems to have learned a great deal from that silver medal winning experience in Rio. And you know what? He's got a spring in his step now, because he's the Olympic champion 5 years on.
I'm surprised he can even walk, you know. I mean, it's just the effort that goes into it. But he, like you said, he has a spring in his step. That was brilliant. The Olympic champion, and tactically, he played that match just perfectly. He really did. Stepped up a gear. And isn't that what great champions do?
It's what Olympic champions do, and he's one of them now. And this, the key moment in the contest. I think he might have been quite pleased with that, the coach. That's what you call a celebration, isn't
well,
it?
Well, I'm wondering how many times we're going to see this little jig in the Olympic highlight reel. Quite a few, I think.
The champion at the Olympic Games, Zhan Vensanovych of Ukraine.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs de la lutte gréco-romaine 87 kg hommes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for wrestling men's Greco-Roman at 87 kilos.
皆様、ただいまよりレスリング男子グレコローマンスタイル 87kg級の表彰式を行います。
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
メダリストをお迎えください。
It's now time for the victory ceremony in Greco-Roman wrestling at Tokyo 2020. And this, the moment for the 87 kilogram weight class, and the wrestlers who have finished top of the rankings.
The medals will be presented by
Monsieur Sergei Bubka, membre du CIO.
That's not a bad medal presenter.
No, he's IOC member. The great pole vaulter himself, and
IOC.
How many times Olympic champion, and how many times did he break the world record?
Accompanied by.
Joining him, Pedro Silva of the governing body of the sport of wrestling.
Portugal.
UWW board member, Portugal.
世界レスリング連合理事, Portugal.
Médaille de bronze, Allemagne et Serbie.
Bronze medalist, Germany and Serbia.
銅メダリストは Deutsch, Serbia.
Denise Kudla and Zurabi Datunashvili.
The presentation of the bronze medals, first of all, starting with Denise Kudla of Germany, who repeats his achievement from Rio de Janeiro 5 years ago. Great display from the two-time Olympic medalist. And Zurab Datunashvili of Serbia, only the second ever wrestling medal won by Serbia at the Olympic Games. His third Olympic Games, the 30-year-old, finally getting on the podium.
Two amazing performances.
Denis Kudla. Zurabi Datunashvili, the bronze medalists.
Hungary,
silver medalist, Hungary.
銀メダリストはハンガリー。
Lőrincz, Viktor.
In 2016, Viktor Lőrincz had to watch on as the Olympic medals were handed out, having lost in the bronze medal contest. Not this time. He is an Olympic silver medalist, the 31-year-old. And he gave it a terrific display as well.
Médaille d'or et champion olympique, Ukraine.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, Ukraine.
金メダリスト、オリンピックチャンピオンは、ウクライナ。
Zhan Vensanovych.
In 2016, Zhan Vensanovych also faced the disappointment of not quite winning the Olympic title. Now he has done just that. The gentleman who's spoken of his desire to create an enduring legacy for sport in Ukraine. One way to do it is to do that as the Olympic champion. We shall now hear the national anthem of Ukraine.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Ukraine.
Ukraina 国歌の演奏です。
Zhan Vensanovych has his moment on top of the world. He is the Olympic champion. Joining him, the medalists in the men's 87kg Greco-Roman competition at Tokyo 2020. He just got it right, didn't he?
Just tactically and technically. I mean, he did everything right, didn't he? He went into a different gear in the second period. As we suspected he would, and yeah, just knew he was going to do it. And we saw on the walk out there, just so confident.
He has an almost strangely gentle quality when wrestling.
Yeah, well, I mean, you mentioned it a couple of times, and you said that he has a way with him, and it's a very comfortable way, isn't it? It almost looks as if he's kind of taking his time to get there, you know, but in the end, he gets there. I think with the great athletes, though, and I used to see it with some of the great runners, you know, they always have a different gear. And the ones that come through in the end are the ones that are able to change gear when it really, really matters.
And you know what? Viktor Lőrincz will doubtless feel the disappointment of almost taking the title, but you've got to look at what the Lőrincz family has accomplished at these games. It's just terrific.
Gold and silver. It's not bad, is it? No. You said about how proud the family must be, and we've had several families that must be very, very proud out there.
And just trailing slightly behind is Zurabi Datunashvili, competing for Serbia and winning them just their second wrestling medal at the Olympic Games.
And now it's time to dance.